a uniform mass distribution rod. Mass is M, length is L. Okay, find out its center of mass using this formula. We know that center of mass will be L by 2. We know that. Prove it. Using that integral formula, prove it. Take a DM mass, it will have dx length at a distance x away. Whenever you encounter integral in physics, initially you will face trouble. So you can't ignore it. You have to get through that. Slowly and slowly you will get a hang of it. Nobody got it? See, you have to take a small mass dm over here. See, mass is spread on entire length L. So dm will occupy some small length dx, let us say. Okay, so let's say the length of dm is dx and it is at a distance of x away. So location of dm is what? X. Fine. Now, do I know dm in terms of x or dx? The entire length L has mass m. So dx length will have what mass? M by L into dx. So this is my dm. So I've got dm in terms of dx. Okay? Fine? This is what you have to do regularly. As in, it is not something which will only come once, and the different scenario will have different way of doing it. This is the way of doing the problems, and this you have to do again and again. So better to understand once and then try to replicate it in the next scenario. Okay? And yes, in the school exams, they will not ask you to integrate and find out the center of mass locations, but they expect you to do in all the competitive exams. Fine, so you should know this. And anyway, if you know only things which everybody else is knowing, you are no good. You are at that left level only. So 15 lakh people write the exam, your rank will also be 5-6 lakhs. Right? Because you have not learned something which others don't know. So why your rank will be better than them? Isn't it? So you should pay attention here. You should know some things which others don't know. And there's nothing very complicated here. So integral of x dm will become what? Integral of x m by l into dx divided by integral dm is what? Total mass m only. So this is my x center of mass. My limits of integral will be what? From 0 to L. X is going from here to here. The masses are distributed starting from here till there. Okay? Now try finding out the answer quickly. M and M goes away. 1 by L comes out of integral. It is constant. 0 to L. X dx. X dx integral is what? X square by 2. 0 to L are the limits, so you get L by 2. L square by 2 will come and 1 L will get cancelled, so L by 2. But suppose you have a rod of length L. Okay? Mass per unit length is given by this. X by L kg per meter. Fine. You need to find center of mass of this rod now. Will it be center of the rod? No. Mass per unit length is increasing. So which side it will be? Right hand side or left hand side? Right hand side. Okay. So your x starts from here, left hand side. Find out where it will be. Same way, exact same way. Answer has to be more than L by 2, otherwise the answer is wrong. Should I do it? Lambda into dx is dm now. Mass per unit length is directly given. In earlier case, you found out mass per unit length, m by l, because it was uniformly distributed. mass per length is kg per meter. That into length is the mass. Okay, imagine a dx element over here at a distance x away. What will be the mass of this dx? Dm will be what? Lambda into dx or not? X dx by n. Any doubts here? Mass per length into the small length will be equal to the small mass. Okay, it's a usual way. So integral of x dm will become integral of x squared dx by L. Got it? So the limits will go from 0 to L divided by the total mass. Total mass, how will you find out? Integral of dm. Integral of dm is what? Integral of x dx by L. Okay? So what do you get here? Tell me quickly.
0 to L.
What is the answer? 2L by 3 or not? You get 2L by 3. Denominator will give you L square by 2. Numerator will give you L cube by 3. So there will be questions like these in JEE Mains where they will give you distribution of mass and you will be asked to find out the center of mass location. It will not be like simple straightforward that 3 point masses are given, their coordinates are given, find out the center of mass. It will not be like that. Okay. Okay, please write down. Semicircular ring. So a semicircular ring is there. Mass is m and the radius is given. Radius is r. You need to find out the center of mass location of this semicircular ring. Okay? Can you tell me, is there a line of symmetry here? Vertical? There is vertical line of symmetry. So your center of mass will lie along this line. Okay? So you don't need to find the x coordinate. You can say this is my y coordinate and this is my x coordinate. So you just need to find out what is the y coordinate of center of mass. Try doing it. The method is similar. In this case, it is better to assume in terms of theta. So if this is theta, this angle is, let's say, d theta. Okay, your dm is the mass of this length. Find out everything in terms of theta and d theta in their integral. Find out integral of y dm divided by integral of dm. This is what you are trying to find out. So y coordinate is what? R sine theta. What is, can you write dm in terms of d theta? How do I write? Suppose this length is dl. The length is dl. So mass of this dl length will be what? Mass of this dl length. Mass per unit length is what? M divided by?
Arey yaar, tum log matlab faltu mein.
Total length is what? Pi r. You are making errors where you should not be. Mass, total length is pi r. So m divided by pi r is mass per unit length. So mass of this dl length will be this into dl. This into dl. Now can you write dl in terms of d theta? R d theta. Right? So I am writing this dm as m divided by pi r into r d theta. So r and r gone. So this will be m d theta by pi. Okay? So r sin theta into m by pi d theta. This is my numerator. Divided by total mass m. The mass is a constant, so you can cancel out like this. Fine. So r by pi will come out of integral. Integral of sin theta d theta. Limits will be what? 0 to? 0 to pi. This angle will change from 0 to pi if I have to cover the entire semicircle. Okay? I am ignoring minus sign. The y coordinate is actually minus of r sine theta. It is negative. Integral of sine theta, you know what it is? Minus cos theta. So this will come out to be r by pi cos theta 0 to pi. Cos of pi is what? Minus 1. Cos of 0 is 1. So minus 1, minus 1. So get minus 2. So this will be equal to minus of 2r by pi. This is the y coordinate of center of mass for the semicircular ring. Okay. Understood? Do it yourself. Don't just copy down. See, again we have followed the same thing, just that angle theta has come. But the way we are finding is same. Mass per unit length into the length. And then integrate it. Okay? Understood? No doubts, right? Nothing. All right. Right now, semicircular disc. Disc of radius r and mass m. Here I will give you a little bit hint. See, now you can't consider your mass to be a small mass because you have to move in entire area. So rather than that, you consider your dm mass to be a ring, a semicircular ring of thickness dr and the radius is small r. So this is your dm. But dm is not a point mass now. So your integral will be transformed into y center of mass of the dm divided by integral of dm. This is what you have to find out for the this time. Okay, and your dm is semicircular ring. And for semicircular ring, you already found out the y center of mass. So use that to find out the center of mass for the disk. And one more thing, mass is distributed on the area, it is not distributed on the length. So you have to find mass per unit area multiplied by the area of this ring to find area. These are little difficult concepts, but you have to know it. What is the area of this semicircular ring? Pi r into dr. You should not find out the area which it encloses. Area of this strip you have to find out. Area of the strip is length of the strip into thickness of the strip. You can take the strip and make a rectangle out of it. You can stretch it like this. So it will become a rectangle. Length pi into small r into width, which is dr. I'll do it now. See, I know you may not be able to get it, but just try it out, do something, then when I tell you, you'll be able to better grasp it. Alright, dm is mass per unit area, which is m divided by area is what? Pi into capital R square by 2. This is mass per unit area into the area of strip. Area of strip is what? Pi into small r into dr. This you got? All of you written this? So pi and pi gone. So you get 2m by r square r dr. This is my dm. Okay? And ycm is what? This. This is what? Minus 2 small r by pi. This is the center of mass location of this strip. Got it? Alright? So all I have to do is substitute here and integrate. So when I substitute, integral of ycm into dm, which is 2m by r square r dr, divided by the total mass m, 0 to small r. Integral of dm is m, which is given to me. This is my y center of mass. Anyone integrated this already? What you will get here?
The radius got cancelled.
Radius got cancelled? No, it will not. इतना खुश हो रहा है रेडियस बट कैंसिल माइनस फोर बाई पाई आर स्क्वायर इंटीग्रल जीरो टू आर आर स्क्वायर डी आर राइट इंटीग्रल आर स्क्वायर डी आर इज व्हाट आर क्यूब बाई थ्री सो व्हेन यू पुट लिमिट जीरो टू सॉरी दिस इज कैपिटल आर सो यू आर गोइंग टू गेट minus of 4r by 3 pi. Getting it? So this, from here up to a distance of 4r by 3 pi down will be the center of mass. Okay? See, why we are doing this? Nobody is going to directly ask you what is the center of mass location of semicircular disk. We are doing this so that you get a habit of finding your center of mass your own when you solve numericals. Okay, this is not part of theory.